Alright, so hello and welcome on my channel, Wolf Aqua, your channel about horticulture, aquaponics and aquaculture. And here we are now today, I'm going to show you my fish system and let's go. So welcome to my wet lab, or let's say a room in my basement where I cultivate my fishies. As you can see here in my back already, there are two fish tanks. Each fish tank has around about 500 liters or half a cubic meter, or like half of an IBC full of water. And I would like to quickly explain you my system. So, like I said, both fish tanks are like a glass aquarium fish tanks, 500 liters each. I gave these fish tanks to myself as a present when I made my when I finished my high school degree. But back in the days, I was a little bit unexperienced, and that's why I guess I forgot to let myself drill some holes inside the glass. And nowadays I talk to different manufacturers and they say, yeah, if you afterwards want to drill a hole in your glass tank or in your glass wall and it's already in a system, then you have like a 50-50 chance that you break the glass or the hole works. And I don't want to take that risk that my whole nice fish tank breaks apart. So that's why I decided to turn it into a pumped system. So let me quickly explain you how my system works. So in each fish tank, I have one water pump or circulation pump, so that water is then pumped out of the fish tank into my pond filter. I put a link in the description of what kind of pond filter I'm using at the moment. And in my pond filter, first the water flows through an UV clarifier to just reduce the amount of bacteria in the water. And then it goes to this very classic pond filtration system where you have different types of mats or medias to collect all the solid substances from the water. And after that, the water flows into my biofilter. So my biofilter is actually this big, big, big black thing here. By the way, both systems are identically built. I let myself build these biofilters based on my own designs and ideas from two different manufacturers just to see who does the better work. And the biofilter works in such a way that the water enters on one side, then the waters travel all the way down in kind of a shaft. And in that shaft, I have a heating system at a strong aeration. So I have this kind of counterflow principle. So the heat and the air rises up and the water goes down. So I hope in this way to increase the efficiency a little bit. And once the water is actually hitting the bottom, it goes all the way up. So it rises all the way up in the main chamber of my biofilter. And from there it flows over back to my fish. And in my main chamber is the biofilter material. And is the biofilter too big for my system? Yes. It is way too big actually. Usually half of the biofilter would be already enough, even if you have a lot of fish in your fish tank. However, I'm not only using this biofilter just for these two few fishies that I have here. By the way, I have two different types of fishies. I have African catfish here and I have largemouth bass in these tanks. And so far they do actually pretty well. So back to the story. So I'm using these biofilters, or the surplus of biofilter volume, actually to cycle biofilter material for customer projects. So when I built a new system, I let myself getting the biofilter media for that system delivered to my place. Then I put this freshly new biofilter media into my system, let it cycle for 6 to 8 weeks. And when I construct the system, I just put the already cycled media into the system and the customer can start raising fish right away with almost no waiting time. Of course, that includes the risk that some diseases that my fish might have, or that the ecosystem of my fish may have or may contain, are getting transferred to the customer. But I make them very well aware of that beforehand. All right, what else? So of course, I have also an aeration system in my fish tanks, and I designed the aeration system so strong that I can actually run with one air pump both systems at the same time. And I always have a spare link or a spare connection point for another air hose on each air pump. So in case one air pump is failing, I can connect one hose to the other air pump and then I can still aerate both of my systems. See, so that is how my system works. And from here I take the water to my plant unit for my decoupled aquaponics system. And how my plant system or my plant section works, I'm going to show you in the next video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions or comments regarding my system, please post in the comment section below the video. It would be super motivating for me to create more content if you subscribe, like, and ring the bell for my channel. And yes, then I hope to see you for the next video when I show you my decoupled aquaponic system, or my plant section. So I show you the irrigation center and I show you my ebb and flow table. All right, but that's in the next video. And ciao.